is going on, everybody? It's your boy SLAPTrain, and welcome back to another episode of Drifting on a Budget. Today we're going to be playing with a set total of, let's say $65,000. All right, so we got 65 G's. We got enough to buy a nice high-end car, but kind of not too many upgrades. So I think this is gonna be a nice mixture of power versus suspension versus just the car in general. So let's see really what we want to do. Now, 65 isn't really a lot of money for a car. I mean, I could really do, if I wanted to, the Nova and just pump in 10 grand worth of upgrades. I mean, that's a possibility. I really kind of wanted to do a muscle car, this one. The Camaro. I don't really like the Camaro stock, really, and I won't be able to do too much to it. Let's see what else we got here first. Fords, possibly. I know I did a Ford a while back, but... The Mustang Mach 1 leaves us with 20 grand left over. That is a possibility as well. Fairlane is just ridiculous. I don't even know why that's so fucking expensive. Let's see. What about Mazda? What do we got for Mazdas? Could do a Mercedes. I know probably a lot of people are wanting Mercedes fucking Benz on this thing. Could even do like a Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she's so thirsty. Noble, no. I don't know. I wanted something like, not like too expensive, but something decent. I could do the Firebird. That thing's nice. Now, Porsche? What do we got for Porsches? 46 grand, actually. That's not too bad. I haven't done a drifting build with a rear engine before. I think that'd be something different and new. What else do I got here? Cars are all overpriced. You know what? Fuck it, let's do it. Rear engine. This car is, what was it, 38 grand? $38,000. So coming off our $65,000 budget, leaves us with $27,000.
Keep track of the latest
news. Whoa, what the hell?
And access your mail for items
purchased
online.
I'm trying to pick my car. Alright. I'm gonna leave this thing silver. So 27 grand. Rear engine drive. Rear engine car or whatever. I don't know what I want to do with this thing. We'll put sport suspension in this thing, make it sporty. You know what I'm saying? Sport. We'll do both of these guys. $2,400 brings us to $21,600 left. So this thing weighs quite a bit already. We're gonna do the street weight reduction for $600. $21,000 left even. Maybe stiffen the chassis up a little bit. So $1,200 gone. $19,800 left. Brakes I don't really care about. We're going to do some engine adjustments though, because we're going to need some engine power on this thing. Let me see what for engine swaps I got. Porsche 997. Quite a bit of horsepower, but that's kind of cheating if I kind of think so anyways. What do I got for... Ooh, I got some body upgrades that I can spend some money on. Let's do the Porsche front bumper. It's probably a waste of money right now, but I want it to look nice right now, you know what I'm saying? Ooh, I like that spoiler. I like that a lot. 500 gone, that's fine with me. So we're blowing about $2,000 on a body kit. Whatever. I like that, that's so clean. All right, we got $18,200 left. And we might as well just go, oh, you know what? I like that side piece. I'm not going to touch that. tires, I'm probably going to leave on its own. I might throw on a set of rims. Just because I've been missing my rims, man. I haven't had rims on these things in forever. But I want to see actually what these stock ones look like. Man, the stock rims on a Porsche, you can't touch them. They just look too nice. Transmission-wise, I'm going to put the Sport Tranny in this thing. $3,000 gone. $15,200 left. We're going to throw on the Sport... you know what? I'm not even going to put a differential in this thing. The clutch, though, I will upgrade to $700. $14,500 left. The rest of it's going to go into the engine. I think I got enough for this. What should I do? I'm going to put the Sport Race Pistons in this thing. 7,400 brings me down. Oh, what the hell? Oh, yeah. Brings me down to 7,100 after that's been put in. And I might as well just throw on the... Oh, I don't even have enough for the exhaust. We'll do the Sport exhaust. Brings me down to $3,500. Can I buy it for 31? Can't even buy a stock. Ooh. Let's do the Sport intercooler. That's 18. 1,700 left. And I wonder if I even have enough for anything right now. It's not looking good. Oh, I can. Oh, there we go. I know it says 1,800, but I've wasted a lot of money on extra budget builds, and I haven't spent it, so I'm throwing this on. So we're negative $100 on this build. First time going over, but that's fine. It's gonna happen. I mean, I gotta play with my money. So let's see what I want. Tops out at 188. I'm gonna kind of extend these gears a little bit. I can't touch any of this, unfortunately. My camber is kind of set. I can't really do much. So the Sport suspension really didn't do very much except for just lower the car a little bit. So that kind of was a waste. I should have just put on the racing suspension. But I can't do anything now, can I? This Porsche just looks absolutely phenomenal. Let's have a look at this thing quickly. I mean, this thing... is just looks like a racing machine. I mean, the headlights look amazing. I like that blue tint actually that's on there too. Beautiful car, absolutely beautiful. So for this one, I have kind of a set track in mind here. I want to throw this on Suzuka. Sorry. I think this is going to be not bad of a track. For the way that the car is anyways. Not a lot of horsepower, but I think it'll be able to power itself through these corners. I really do hope so. We didn't throw on any tires, so I mean, the tires aren't really a problem. I think it's going to slide the way that I want it to. Just a matter of fact, if it's going to deliver on what I want. You know what I'm saying? What I want. All right. Let's see what we get. Car sounds amazing. Having this Porsche pack, if you guys don't have this pack, it's really your way, you're really missing out on a lot of good stuff. So I like the horsepower right off the bat. Ooh, I didn't like how that second gear just dropped. Shit. I might have to yeah, this might be a crap. Oh, you know what? I took that not bad. Alright, second gear seems like it wants the bog. We'll have to wait and see. Might be okay in these short sections. Man, that's ugly. My first gear is too fucking long. I mean, short. We might have to go back and work on the suspension. The gearing, sorry. I'll give it one more run just to be sure, but yeah, this thing is way too grippy. I'm actually really surprised. Well, that's the shit I don't like. Let's get these tires heat. Alright, what do we got on here, 29 PSI. I'm going to bring up the PSI and probably shorten the gearing as well. This thing is just ridiculous. It's way too grippy. Yeah, I can't even get to the next angle on these corners. See if I can just try to get some ridiculous angle there. Wow, that was nice. So, that was an amazing angle at the very end, though, I will say that. Okay, let's see what I can do with this suspension, or the gearing, sorry. I don't even know if it's the gears, though, really. I mean, I just don't think this thing has enough horsepower, to be honest with you. We're going to throw up this tire pressure because I think that's one of the biggest problems. We're going to jack it up because, really, this car is way too fucking grip. I don't know. I don't know if that's going to help or not. I really don't. We might have made a boo-boo on this car. We just destroyed a Porsche. I mean, if all else fails, this thing makes for a great wall unit. We're making it into a race car bed, too. That'd be sick. We make it all kinds of race car bed. Oh, sunset's going to help me drift for sure. There's no more sun on the pavement, which doesn't make the car sticky. You know what I'm saying? Oh my god, no. It's going to be crazy. This is outrageous. Crazy. I fucking hope this car fixes itself, man. I want to drift this thing. I could have tuned my car right there. Are you serious? I just seen that too. Sorry. Alright, PI pressure, let's do this. I still don't like this second gear, man. The second gear does not have enough pull. Oh my god. This car is giving me problems. I think the key for this car is to really initiate as much as possible. So try to get as much angle as you can on the initiation. And then let it go. Because this rear engine is a lot different than drifting front engine. All the way to the back of your car. So I think that's another problem. Is that when I go to slide this thing, I need as much angle as physically possible. I'm going to take this thing around the track, actually. Because when this thing really gets going, all that weight is just fucking sitting there, sliding. And it's wanting to slide, but it's very hard to get out. So in terms of it being a rear engine car, I mean, it's not bad. It's just the fact that when I wanted to really connect on these corners, it's very hard. And look at that. When I need it on these short corners, it's there. But in terms of connecting corners on a long road, it's not going to happen because the engine just wants to come back in. Right? I mean, it wants to just catch and get all that grip because that's really where all the grip is on the rear tire. So it's very hard to get that grip going. I mean, to really loosen that grip. And really, the only way to do that is to just slide it out, hit the turn, and get as much angle as physically possible. Because that's really the only way where this car is going to actually slide out properly. So, in terms of this track, probably wasn't the best choice of a track. If you guys want to try this car out on a different track, by all means, let me know how this thing is. But I don't think this is the proper suit of track. I thought it was going to be, but I guess not. It's doing bad. Grip, you bitch! There we go. So So yeah, this thing is definitely a lot different, especially when you don't have a lot of horsepower. I think that's where, like, even my wheel feels different right now. Like, it wants to just rip. My wheel just wants to fucking take off. So first and second gear, if second gear had a little bit more pull to it, I think this thing would have been amazing. And that's the key word, though. It had to have some extra pull. That's where the problems are in this car. There we go. Oh, I didn't. What? All right, fuck that corner. All right. This will be my last lap on this thing. So right here is not bad. When I get some speed and these tires, I think, get warmed up, it's not bad. I mean, right here, I'm pulling some good angles, connecting the corners. So, I mean, I really shouldn't blame the car too much. I think it really has to do with the tires getting warmed up. I put the PI pretty high, right? So, I mean, once they get going, it's even higher than what it was. We're going to run this section just right back just to see if it's any better than what it was the first time. I think it's going to be honest. Excuse me, sir. All right. Don't you fucking hit that. Oh my God, dude. Come on, man. Got all nervous from that corner. Come on, hold that bitch. Hold it. In the grass, I love it. There we go. Let's go for the good old spin-off just to finish it. All right, we got the spin. All right, gentlemen. So, 2 cents on this car. It's a nice car. I mean, it is. I mean, the track probably wasn't the greatest section for it. So I do apologize for that. But I really thought it was going to be nice. I thought it was going to slide on this track, but it really didn't. Overall, though, the car needed a little bit more extra horsepower. So I think if I could have not bought so many fucking body upgrades, I think the car would have been nice. But at the flip side of the coin, I needed a little bit more horsepower, which would have maybe costed me around another 12 grand to really get it to where I wanted it. Me personally, anyways, right? So I think if this car was on Iberian Mini or any of the other smaller tracks, later test track, to scuba short on the smaller sections, car would have been amazing. So as I said, if you guys want to try out this tune, let me know how it is on some of the smaller tracks. And that's really about it. So thank you guys very much for watching this episode. It's your boy, the SLAP Train. Till next one, I'm out. Peace.